Hi folks, this is David Kwan here. In this video, I'm going to talk briefly, or try to talk briefly at least, I know I tend to talk a lot, about Mod Nation Racers, which I played on the PlayStation Vita. I got it for really cheap price, I think. It was on sale. It was one of those PlayStation Network racing sale that was going on. So I got it for like, I don't remember, I think it was under $5 that I got this for. So that's why I got it. But it's interesting. So the whole thing about Mod Nation Racers when it came out, the selling point is, you know, you can kind of create your own levels, you can customize your characters and things like that. So that's definitely in there. I haven't really done any kind of creation with the courses, whatever. It's there, but with the beta, like, I feel like it's kind of, you would think it's a lot intuitive because it's a touch screen and whatnot, but I found it kind of hasslesome, and it's more kind of cumbersome than I thought it would be. So I didn't really do too much of that. Also, like, sharing levels is not as easy, at least on the beta. I don't know how, I haven't played the PS3 version, so I don't know how that is. But just on the beta, the online aspect of it is really disappointing. It's just, like, it's almost like it's really not there. I could download characters that people customize, but I don't want to do that. I want to be able to play courses that people created, and if it works really well, that would motivate me to create courses that other people would play on and play them together. And that's kind of missing. The online aspect is sorely missing. And in a game, this genre, you know, play, create, share, the genre of Media Molecule, is that's important to be able to share, create, and share. The share part is missing in this game. So that also impacts the create part. If you can't share, then why create, you know? I mean, there is sharing, but it's such a limited sharing. And the whole thing about kind of customizing your character is a cool concept, but I think with something like Little Big Planet, it worked because Sackboys and Sackgirls were super cute, and it was really fun to do. Mods, the characters in this game, it doesn't really, it's hard to get attached to them, I feel like. And sure, it's cool to customize your carts and your characters, but it's just not as charming as something like Media Molecule was able to accomplish with Little Big Planet. So on the aspect for this game, on the aspect of creating and sharing, not so great, I felt, you know. But I also read around that in the reviews and stuff that this is even more so true for the beta version. I think I've read that for the PlayStation 3 version, it's a lot better, at least the creating and the sharing aspect of it. So that leaves us with the playing aspect. And this game, for me, kind of took some going, you know, I was getting used to it, but it is a fun game. The environments are really cool, the course designs, it starts out kind of, oh, this is our car game, to going into, like, holy crap, well, okay, there's branching paths, there's like places where you have to go flying in the air, and you have to do stunts, and you have to make sure that you roll just enough times to land with the boost. And the boost meter gauge is a really cool concept. So the more you drip, the more you build on that boost gauge, the more you attack someone, the more you pass someone, the things that you do in your racing, you know, as you do, it just raises your boost gauge. Whatever you do is that is good for racing. And then when you get it all that way up high, you can press a button to start using that boost and just boost your way out of there. So being able to use your boost to gather the boost and to use the boost when you want to, that is a really cool thing. That's for me, was what made Mod Nation Racer a lot fun, so much fun at sometimes. It's just like, holy crap, I'm at sixth place, I'm still behind, but look, I have this boost meter. I'm going to be like, catch up really quickly. I mean, even sometimes I get so far behind that it doesn't really help all that much. But it does help, you know, and you can see other characters, computer characters, trying to do the same thing. And it's really cool. The AI, like, is the computer AI is, I don't know, it's not that frustrating as some games, like freaking MotorStorm. AI of that game, you know, but it's not too bad. The controls are pretty good, except it always feels like I'm going really slow. For kart racer games, you're usually not going so fast, so you don't really sense the speed is not that important in these kind of games. But for Moderation Racers, I felt like I was going so slow. And I was just like, sometimes I was wondering, am I pressing the... Sorry, this is a Wii U controller, I know. Like, my Vita is like stuck in the corner somewhere. But I was just like, am I pressing the drive button? Am I pressing the accelerate button? Come on, just go. And it doesn't really go that fast. So that is kind of a disappointment, especially when you bump into a wall. It really like just stops you, or not stops you, but it really impacts your speed. You start going so slow. And there are these areas where the courses, the later courses in the campaign, they're designed to like kind of be like to hinder you. Some courses are super challenging, super difficult, which is cool on the other hand. Cool on one hand, but on the other hand, it's kind of frustrating when you get into a trap. When you're doing so well in the course, and you're like, can I make that shortcut? Nope. Poof, just fell right there. Now I was in first place, now I'm in fourth place. Shit. You know? So that happens, and another thing, I really like the weapons in this game, just because of the concept of being able to upgrade your weapons while racing is really cool. So the play aspect of Moderation Racers, they did a really lot of cool things. The thing about weapons that I have a gripe about, though, that I have a complaint about, though, is that the impact that I feel when I use weapons is not that great. See, the thing about games like Mario Kart and Crash Bandicoot is when you use that red shell, you see that red shell or green shell or whatever weapon you use, rockets or whatever, you see that weapon going from your cart to the other cart, and you know, you see it making an impact. Whereas Moderation Racers, all the weapons are just kind of like, you use it, and shoo, shoo, stuff happens. I'm like, I don't know what's going on. Oh, he's affected. That other guy, he escaped my attack. Like, why? Doesn't really, you know, even, so this is kind of the area where Wipeout has a complaint, you know, Wipeout franchise, people complain, like, I don't know if my weapons are doing the impact that I need to be doing, but Moderation Racer has definitely got to be the worst in this regard. Like, I use a weapon, I think I hit people, I think I just did a lot of damage, but I'm not really sure, you know, it's the hit detection of kart games, and Moderation Racer does not do a good job of that. But being able to upgrade my weapon, so I get a weapon or a power-up, and then if I hit another power-up again, so if I hit a question mark in the Mario Kart game, you know, when I have a weapon, when I have an item, that does nothing. But in this game, if I have a power-up and I hit another power-up, then what I have gets upgraded to level 2. If I hit it again, it gets upgraded to level 3, and it does something completely amazing, each one. So that is just really freaking cool. Level design, for the most part, is really imaginative. I played Mario Kart 8 right after I played Moderation Racers, and I have to say, some of the level design, some of the course designs in Moderation Racers are superior to Mario Kart 8, which I was not expecting. It's just there's so much imagination and creativity in these Moderation Racers courses, which I thought was really cool. Of course, Mario Kart 8 just feels so... The play, like the controls feel so much tighter in Mario Kart 8, and the levels just are so gorgeous, and the environment's like just so much colors. And that's what makes Mario Kart 8 just like, you know, graphics makes that game boom. You know, and Moderation Racers is not a bad looking game, and it's certainly a colorful game as well, but it not to that degree, you know? So it's a pretty interesting game. The disappointing thing is it's a play, create, share genre. But the only thing that you can really do in this game is to play, which I think is really disappointing, at least on the Vita side. So I don't know how it is on the PS3 side. So it may be on the PS3 side, the creating and sharing is a lot better. In which case, you know, that would make Moderation Racer game to like such an amazing game. But it does make this playing this on the Vita really makes me want to check out, you know, Moderation Racers on the PS3 and also Little Big Planet. Kart racing, because I know that's out there too, but I haven't really played those games. I'll be totally, incredibly late to the party on that, on those games. But yeah, these are my thoughts on Moderation Racers for the PS Vita. Hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.